Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a member count channel. So inside of the Warnoff Keys Discord, if you look at the top, we see a channel called Discord Members :50, and this will automatically update whenever someone joins or leaves the Discord, and this is what we're going to be creating within this video. To get started, I have this basic project here. You can clone this project from the GitHub repository found in the video description, or you can code launch from scratch. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new file. This will be called member-count.js. And we are going to import that file into our main index file. So constant member count equals require member count. We're then going to run the function that this will export, simply running member count and passing in the client. And now we can save this and close the file. All of our logic will be inside of our member count file. So because we ran a method, we actually have to export one. So module.exports equals a function that will have the client as a parameter. Now we need to actually create a channel. So if we go into our Discord, under the Warnoff Keys category, I can click on create channel. This will be a voice channel. And we can type in members : I'm going to make this a private channel so people don't see it. However, yours will probably be public. If we go to owner, I'm going to select that and then create my channel. One thing to keep in mind is that we want to edit the channel and edit the permissions. We want to make sure that connect is disallowed so people can actually join this channel. And then I'm also going to drag this channel all the way up here on top of everything else. Keep in mind there are no numbers on this channel as of now. However, you will see those in a few seconds once we get our code working. So now that we have this channel, we can actually right click and copy ID. And if you don't see this, you have to enable the developer mode on your Discord account. So going back, we can create a constant called channel ID, and we can paste it in right here. So now I'm going to create a function called update members. So constant update members, and this is going to take one parameter, which is a guild, and we are going to get a channel from that guild. So constant channel equals guild.channels.cache.get channel ID. And this is the syntax to actually retrieve a channel from a guild, passing in the ID of the channel. So now we can say channel.setName, and we're going to pass in a template literal using backticks, and we'll say members : space, and then we're going to insert the actual member count. So we have guild.memberCount, and then this should actually update it. However, I like to always add .toLocalString, and this will actually make it so if we add a number like 500, 500 will be there. But if we add a number like 1,300, then it'll add the comma to it and give us 1,300. If you don't want this, obviously you can just not use this function call. However, this is what I prefer. And if you prefer that as well, then you can use this right here. So if we get rid of those, we now want to listen to whenever someone joins or leaves our server. To do that, we can say client.onGuildMemberAdd. And this is going to give us a function as a callback with a member parameter. We can then call update members and pass in member.guild because this function requires a guild object. We can then copy and paste this line here, and we want to change guild member add to guild member remove. We'll have our member object like normal. And so with both of these said, whenever someone joins or leaves our Discord, it's going to actually update that specific channel. Now, one thing I like to do in this specific case, which is useful if you are only developing on for your own server, or whenever you're just learning. However, this next step is not useful if your bot is publicly used on multiple Discords. And the one thing I want to do here is I want to automatically update the channel whenever the bot actually starts up. The benefit to this is whenever, let's say your bot is down for a little bit for whatever reason and it starts back up, it will automatically update the member count to the correct total without waiting for someone to join or leave to then do it. The reason why I mentioned that you should only use this if you're using a single server with your bot is because we essentially have to get the guild and then we want to update the channel from that guild. However, if your bot is inside of multiple servers, that doesn't seem to work too well, and I'll be covering how to make your bot work with multiple servers in the future. If it's uploaded, then you will see that at the top right of your screen or in the video description. But moving forward, we now want to get our guild object. So constant guild equals client.guilds.cache.get, and we want to pass in a string. This is very similar to how we got our channel. It's the same syntax in Discord V12. So we can go into Discord, we can right click on our server, and we can click on copy ID. Going back, we can paste this in. We then want to say update members and pass in our guild. If we go back to Discord, we see there's no number on our members channel. If we are to save this and then run node index.js to start a bot, we see the client is ready. And if we go back, we see members is 50. And this is because it automatically got the guild and updated it right here. That way, I didn't have to wait for someone to join or leave to see the change. However, when someone does join and whenever someone does leave, it's going to automatically update due to these two listeners right here. And this is how you're going to create an actual member count channel, just like you saw on my Discord server. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.